We're here with Trisha from Luxury Daily. Trisha, why do you think that Cartier chose the New York Magazine for these ads?
I think it's a good placement just because New York is the largest market in the United States. And I think that people that read The Cut are not only interested in fashion and luxury, but they're also interested in the business behind it and just the latest news and the latest updates on the collections and new products in the fashion industry. So I think they were definitely looking to tap those consumers that are reading that blog but are also purchasing luxury goods, and I think that that's a great move overall. You obviously can't miss the Cartier brand message just because it is all over The Cut on New York Magazine once you transfer to the blog. So overall, I think it will definitely hit its target of that really fashion-savvy consumer that might have the money to splurge on one of the new Tink pieces.
And do you think that Cartier was, had a better option for marketing on the homepage, or was The Cut a better choice for it?
I actually think that the fashion section is definitely a good choice, only because I think that it definitely keeps a more targeted audience. I think that if you are appealing to the wider the audience you're appealing to, it might dilute the brand a little bit. Not to say that New York Magazine isn't read by affluent consumers, but currently right now the ad on the New York Magazine's homepage is for a TV show, so that might just signal what types of ads are usually displayed there, and then the distinction within the fashion blog. I would have loved to see the ads on other fashion content as well as just The Cut blog, but overall I think it's definitely trying to stay within its target audience with these ads.